Good morning.
Dobré ráno.
I hope you had a good night.
Dúfam, že ste mali príjemnú noc. Dobrú noc.
We are going to have an exciting study this morning.
Budeme mať toto ráno veľmi zaujímavé štúdium.
I do not want to speak a long introduction.
Nechcem hovoriť nejaký dlhý úvod.
Because there's much content that we want to share.
Pretože mám veľa obsahu, ktorý chcem zdieľať.
From the Bible and from history.
Z Biblie a z dejín.
Of course we cannot say everything that could be said on this topic.
Samozrejme nemôžeme povedať všetko, čo sa dá povedať o tejto téme.
In the little amount that we have of time.
V tomto malom období času, ktoré máme.
But we'll do our best to give you a very clear overview.
Ale urobíme maximum preto, aby ste dostali vlastne veľmi jasný prehľad toho.
Of the prophetic roots that our church is built upon.
O tých prorockých cestách, na ktorých je prorockých koreňoch, na ktorých je postavená naša cirkev.
And I hope after this lecture you will know why you are a Seventh-day Adventist.
A dúfam, že po tejto lekcii, po tejto prednáške budete vedieť, prečo ste adventisti 7. dňa.
So let's kneel down for a word of prayer.
Takže kľakneme si k modlitbe.
And then we'll start.
A potom môžeme začať.
Dear Father in heaven.
Drahý Otec v nebesiach.
We come to you as we are.
Prichádzame k tebe takí, akí sme.
Sinful, erring humans.
Hriešne, chybné bytosti.
Weak in our own power.
Slabí v našej vlastnej sile.
All our promises are failing.
Všetky naše sľuby zlyhávajú.
And we know that we need you.
A vieme, že teba potrebujeme.
You alone can make us clean.
Len ty sám nás môžeš očistiť.
You alone can help us to understand truth.
Jedine ty sám nám môžeš dať porozumieť pravde.
You alone can make Bible prophecy clear to our minds.
Jedine ty sám môžeš objasniť biblické proroctvá našim mysliam.
And so I pray this morning.
A tak sa toto ráno modlím.
That you will be in this place.
Aby si bol na tomto mieste.
Despite all our shortcomings and failures.
Napriek všetkým našim nedostatkom a zlyhaniam.
That you will speak to our souls.
Aby si prehováral k našim dušiam.
That you will encourage us.
Aby si nás povzbudil.
And give us your light.
A dal nám svoje svetlo.
According to your promise.
Podľa svojho sľubu.
We ask this.
Prosíme ťa o to.
In the precious name of Jesus Christ.
V drahom mene Ježiša Krista.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's turn our Bibles.
Otvorme si naše Biblie.
To the book of Revelation.
Do knihy Zjavenia.
We'll start our search in Revelation chapter 10.
Začneme naše hľadanie, naše štúdium v Zjavení Jána, 10. kapitole.
In Revelation chapter 10 verse 1.
Zjavenie 10. kapitola verš 1.
We read.
Čítame.
That John on Patmos is saying,
že Ján na ostrove Patmos hovorí,
I saw still another mighty angel coming down from heaven.
A videl som iného anjela silného, zostupujúceho z neba, odiatého oblakom.
Clothed with a cloud,
odiatého oblakom,
and a rainbow was on his head,
a na jeho hlave bola dúha.
His face was like the sun,
jeho tvár bola ako slnce,
and his feet like pillars of fire.
A jeho nohy ako ohnivé stĺpy.
First question.
Prvá otázka.
Who is this person brought to view in this passage?
Kto je tá osoba, ktorá je tu opísaná v tejto pasáži?
Why do you say Jesus?
Prečo hovoríte Ježiš?
What evidence from the verse do you have that this is Jesus?
A na základe akých dôkazov v tomto verši tvrdíme, že je to Ježiš?
According to view, to appearance.
Yeah, what exactly in his appearance totally points to Jesus.
Čo presne v tom vzhľade ukazuje priamo na Ježiša?
Shining.
Yeah, thank you.
Áno, ďakujem.
His face shone like the sun.
Jeho tvár svietila ako slnko.
We have other verses in the Bible where Jesus clearly is depicted as with a shining face.
Máme iné verše v Biblii, kde Ježiš je jasne opísaný ako so svietiacou tvárou.
For example, Revelation 1.
Napríklad Zjavenie 1.
Verse 16.
Verš 16.
Where it says about Jesus.
Kde o Ježišovi je napísané.
He had in his right hand seven stars, out of his mouth went a sharp two-edged sword.
A vo svojej pravej ruke mal 7 hviezd a z jeho úst vychádzal ostrý dvojsečný meč.
And his countenance was like the sun shining in its strength.
A jeho tvár bola ako slnko, keď svieti vo svojej moci.
Also when we consider the story of the transfiguration.
Tiež keď uvažujeme nad príbehom o na vrchu premenenia.
Where we also saw Jesus when his face shone like the sun.
Kde jeho tvár tiež svietila ako slnko.
So biblically there can be no doubt this is Jesus in Revelation 10.
Takže z biblického hľadiska nemôže byť pochyb o tom, že v tom Zjavení 10 je reč o Ježišovi.
There are four characteristics given here of him.
Sú tu dané 4 charakteristiky, 4 vlastnosti, ktoré ho charakterizujú.
First of all, he has a face that shines like the sun.
Za prvé, má teda tvár, ktorá svieti ako slnko.
Now in the Bible, what does the sun or the light represent?
Nuž a teraz v Biblii, čo slnko alebo svetlo reprezentuje?
Truth, okay.
God.
God, yeah.
Boh, áno.
Can you give any Bible verse for your assertion?
Môžete dať nejaké biblické verše na tie vaše predpoklady? Na vaše odpovede? In Psalm that God is sun.
Yeah, God is our sun, yeah.
In Psalm.
Let's turn our Bibles to 2 Corinthians.
Otvorme si Biblie v 2 Corinthians.
2 Corinthians.
Druhá Korintianom.
Chapter 4.
Kapitola 4.
Verse 4.
Verš 4. Čiže 2 Korintianom 4:4.
2 Corinthians 4 verse 4. Whose minds the God of this age has blinded, who do not believe, lest the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine on them.
U ktorých Boh tohoto sveta oslepil zmysly neveriacich, aby sa im nezablesklo osvietenie evanjelia slávy Kristovej, ktorý je obrazom Boha.
So what is the light?
Takže čo je to svetlo?
It's the gospel.
Gospel alebo evangelium.
The gospel of the glory of the character of Jesus.
Evangelium o vlastnosti o
the glory of the
evangelium the glory of Jesus. O sláve Ježiša Krista.
Two verses down in verse 6.
O dva verše neskôr ďalej.
It says for it is the God who commanded light to shine out of darkness.
Vo verši 6. Kde sa píše, lebo je to Boh, ktorý povedal, aby sa zo tmy zaskvelo svetlo.
Who has shone in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ.
Ktorý sa zaskvel v našich srdciach na osvietenie známosti slavy Božej v tvári Ježiša Krista.
This very ability of God.
Presne táto schopnosť Boha.
To say let there be light.
Nech je svetlo,
ktorý
môže povedať, nech je svetlo, a to
even
svetlo je
in the darkness,
dokonca aj v tme
and the, emptiness,
a v prázdnote
and on, in the chaos of our heart,
a v tom chaose našich srdc.
Has anyone witnessed in his own life this power of God?
Bol niekto, kto zažil takúto moc Boha vo vlastnom živote?
I have witnessed that power.
Ja som bol svedkom takejto moci.
Even if it's dark and empty inside.
Aj keď je vnútri tma a prázdnota.
God can say let there be light.
Boh môže povedať nech je svetlo.
And not because of our own efforts.
A nie kvôli našim vlastným zásluhám.
But because of his grace.
Ale pre jeho milosť.
There is light.
Je teda to svetlo.
That is the light of the gospel of Christ in his face.
Je to svetlo evanjelia v tvári Ježiša.
When we look into the face of Jesus, we see this gospel.
Keď sa pozeráme do tvári Ježiša Krista, tak vidíme toto evanjelium.
But that angel in Revelation 10 has not only a face shining as a sun.
Ale ten anjel v Zjavení 10. kapitole má to svetlo iba v tvári.
Has not only.
Nie len v tvári.
He has also a rainbow associated with him.
Má dokonca aj duhu spojenú so sebou.
Now what does a rainbow represent?
Čo teda tá duha reprezentuje? Promise.
The promise, yeah.
Smluva. Sľuba, sľub teda. Grace, milosť. Grace.
Now, where do we find the first rainbow?
Kde nachádzame prvú dúhu? After the flood.
After the flood, it was a sign of a covenant between God and humanity.
Bolo to znamenie zmluvy medzi Bohom a ľudstvom.
God said, I made a covenant. I make a covenant. I will not destroy the earth again by flood.
Boh hovorí, ja robím teraz tú zmluvu a dávam vám zmluvu, že už viacej nezničím zem potopou.
So the rainbow is a symbol of God's covenant.
Takže tá dúha je symbolom Božej zmluvy.
When do you see a rainbow?
Kedy vidíte dúhu? After rain, when there is sun.
So when there's rain and sun coming together, right?
Čiže keď príde dážď a slnko spolu.
If you have only sun without rain, there's no rainbow.
Keď máte iba slnko, ale nemáte dážď, tak nie je dúha.
If you have only rain without sun, there's no rainbow.
A naopak, keď máte iba dážď a nie je slnko, tak nie je
dúha. So the sun is a symbol of what?
Takže slnko je symbolom čoho? Covenant?
No, the sun, we already said the sun is a symbol of.
Už sme to povedali, čiže slnko je symbolom čoho? God.
The gospel. Right?
Evanjelia.
The light of the gospel.
Svetlo evanjelia.
The good news, the grace of God. The good news, the grace of God.
Dobrá správa a milosti Boha.
But what does rain represent in the story of Noah?
Ale čo dážď reprezentuje v tom príbehu Noého? Čo dážď reprezentuje v tom príbehu? Destruction.
It was righteous judgment, right?
Bolo to spravodlivý rozsudok, spravodlivý trest.
God was punishing the impenitent sinners.
Boh trestal nekajúcich sa hriešnikov.
So when you have rain and sun together,
takže ak máte dážď a slnko naraz,
it's like righteousness,
je to ako spravodlivosť,
and judgment,
a rozsudok, súd,
meeting the gospel and grace,
stretávajúce sa s evanjeliom a s milosťou.
That is a covenant of God.
To je zmluva od Boha.
In God's covenant,
v Božej zmluve,
the grace of God,
milosť Božia,
and his judgment meet.
A jeho súd sa stretávajú.
So Jesus is depicted with the gospel but also with the covenant.
Takže Ježiš je opísaný nielen evanjeliom, ale aj tou zmluvou.
But then we have two other symbols.
Ale potom tam máme dva ďalšie symboly.
The cloud and fire, right?
Oblak a oheň.
Now when you think about cloud and fire,
keď si teda predstavíme oblak a oheň,
what Bible story comes to your mind?
A ktorý biblický príbeh príde do vašich myslí? Elijah. Elijah.
Elijah, okay, yeah. Cloud and fire, yeah.
Eliáš. God leading the people.
God leading the people out of Egypt towards the promised land.
Boh vedúci ľudí z Egypta do zasľúbenej zeme.
The cloud and fire were symbols of God leading his people.
Oblak a oheň symbolizoval Boha, ktorý viedol svoj ľud.
So in Revelation 10 we have Jesus coming down from heaven.
Takže v Zjavení 10, keď Ježiš prichádza z neba,
he comes with the gospel and the covenant.
Prichádza s evanjeliom a so zmluvou.
In order to lead his people.
Aby viedol svoj ľud.
But in Revelation 10 actually says if you go back,
ale v tom Zjavení 10 sa v podstate píše,
that he is an angel.
Že je anjel.
Now why is Jesus depicted as an angel?
Teraz prečo je Ježiš opísaný ako anjel? Zobrazený ako anjel.
What does angel mean?
Čo anjel teda
messenger,
predstavuje?
Right?
Je to posol však.
Now what is the characteristic of a messenger?
A čo je teraz charakteristikou posla?
What makes a man or woman a messenger?
Čo urobíš z muža alebo zo ženu posla? Message.
A message, right?
Správa, áno.
So Jesus is seen here as someone who has a message.
Takže Ježiš je tu na videný ako niekto, kto má správu, posolstvo.
Jesus comes symbolically speaking from heaven to earth.
Ježiš prichádza symbolicky, symbolicky povedané z neba na zem.
With a special message.
So špeciálnym posolstvom.
The angel is seen in symbolic language.
Ten anjel je ako symbolická reč.
With one foot on the sea and one foot on the land.
S jednou nohou na mori a s druhou nohou na zemi.
Don't miss that.
Na toto si všimnite, nezabudnite na to.
We're coming to this in a moment.
O chvíľku sa k tomu vrátime.
And this message somehow has to do with a book.
A toto posolstvo má niečo s knihou.
Because in verse 2 it says.
Pretože vo verši 2 hovorí.
He had a little book open in his hand.
A vo svojej ruke mal otvorenú knižku.
And he set his right foot on the sea and his left foot on the land.
A svoju pravú nohu položil na more a ľavú na zem.
Now, if we know that Jesus has a message,
už teraz ak vieme, že Ježiš mal posolstvo,
we safely can conclude that this message has to do something with the book in his hand, right?
Môžeme bezpečne povedať, že to posolstvo má niečo spoločné s tou knihou v jeho ruke.
Because in the next verse it says and he cried out with a loud voice.
Pretože v ďalšom hovorí, v ďalšom verši sa píše a skríkol veľkým hlasom.
This message is not a whisper tone.
Toto posolstvo nie je povedané v šepkaní.
It shall be a global message.
Má to byť globálne posolstvo.
It must be a message about the gospel.
Má to byť posolstvo o evanjeliu.
It must be a message about the covenant.
Má to byť posolstvo o zmluve.
And it must be a message that will lead God's people nearer to the promised Canaan.
A má to byť posolstvo, ktoré privedie Boží ľud bližšie k zasľúbenému Kanánu.
You follow so long?
Sledujete ma zatiaľ?
Okay. Now, this little book.
A teraz táto malá knižka.
Is open.
Je otvorená.
Now the original language.
Ten pôvodný jazyk.
Actually says it is opened.
V skutočnosti hovorí, že je otvorená. Sa otvára.
So there's a difference whether the book is open or opened.
Je rozdiel v tom, že či je kniha otvorená alebo sa otvára.
Meaning at some time it was closed.
Čo znamená, že v istom bode času bola zatvorená.
And now it has been opened.
A teraz sa otvára.
That's what is the case here.
To je vlastne tento prípad.
So Jesus brings a book.
Takže Ježiš prináša knihu,
that had been closed,
ktorá bola zavretá,
and now is opened.
A teraz je už otvorená, otváraná.
Question.
Otázka.
Where in the Bible do we find a book that had been closed?
Kde v Biblii nájdeme knihu, ktorá bola zatvorená?
The book of Daniel. Okay, you're a good Adventist.
Kniha Daniela, áno, ste dobrí adventisti.
Let's see how far we can get with this.
Uvidíme, ako ďaleko sa s tým dostaneme.
Where do we find the closing of the book of Daniel?
Kde nájdeme zatvorenie tej knihy u Daniela?
What chapter of Daniel?
V ktorej kapitole? 12.
Very good. Daniel chapter 12.
Daniel kapitola 12, áno.
The Bible says in verse 4.
Biblia hovorí vo verši 4.
But you Daniel shut up the words and seal the book until the time of the end.
A ty Danielu zavrite slova a zapečať knihu až do času, keď bude mať byť koniec.
Many shall run to and fro and knowledge shall increase.
Mnohí budú spytovať a rozmnoží sa vedomosť.
Here we find a sealed book, a closed book.
Tu nachádzame zapečatenú, zavretú knihu.
But the Bible clearly says it will not be closed forever.
Ale Biblia jasne hovorí, že nebude zavretá na veky.
It will be closed how long?
Bude zavretá ako dlho? Until the time of the end.
Until the time of the end.
Až do konca času.
Now question.
Teraz otázka.
I'm curious.
Som zvedavý.
Was the entire book of Daniel closed?
Bola celá kniha u Daniela zavretá?
Yes or no?
Áno alebo nie?
Yes?
No.
No. Let me ask you.
Dovolte sa ma opýtať.
Was Daniel chapter 1 understandable even before the time of the end?
Chapter 1?
Chapter 1. The first chapter, was it understandable prior to the time of the end?
Prvá kapitola Daniela pochopiteľná aj pred, teda prvá kapitola Daniela pochopiteľná aj pred časom konca?
Yes or no?
Áno alebo nie?
Yes. Was it chapter 3 understandable prior to the time of the
end? Bola kapitola číslo 3 tiež pochopiteľná pred časom konca?
Was Daniel 2 or Daniel 9 understandable before?
Boli pochopiteľné kapitoly 2 alebo 9?
Of course, otherwise Jesus could never have said the time is fulfilled.
Samozrejme, lebo inak by Ježiš nemohol povedať, že čas sa naplnil.
So I would say quite a great portion of the book of Daniel was not sealed at all.
Môžeme povedať teda, že pomerne veľká časť z knihy Daniela nebola zavretá.
So what portion of the book of Daniel was actually sealed?
Tak ktorá časť tej knihy Daniela bola naozaj zapečatená?
Let's find out.
Nájdime to.
In Daniel chapter 8.
U Daniela v kapitole 8, v kapitole 8.
The Bible says.
Biblia hovorí.
In Daniel chapter 8 verse 26.
Daniel 8 verš 26.
And the vision of the evenings and mornings which was told is true.
A videnie večera a rána, o ktorom bolo povedané, je pravda.
Therefore seal up the vision.
A ty zavri videnie.
For it refers to many days in the future.
Lebo sa vzťahuje na dobu o mnoho dní.
Now, teraz. Would you agree that Daniel 8 was sealed, yes or no?
Budete súhlasiť s tým, že Daniel, Daniel 8?
8.
Daniel kapitola 8 bola zapečatená?
Áno alebo nie? Yes or no?
Áno alebo nie?
No, no, you're not paying attention.
Nie, nedávate pozor.
I did not, I asked you whether the chapter 8 was sealed.
Otázka je, či 8. kapitola bola zapečatená.
Could people understand that the ram was Medo-Persia?
A mohli ľudia pochopiť, že ten barán bol Medo-Persia?
Yes or no?
Áno alebo nie?
Could people understand that the gold was Greece?
Mohli ľudia pochopiť, že tá koza bola, ten kozol bol Grécko?
Could people understand that the little horn was Rome? That the little horn was Rome.
Mohli ľudia pochopiť, že ten malý roh bol Rím?
Yes, so was the chapter 8 sealed?
Takže bola kapitola 8 zapečatená?
No, what was sealed according to the verse?
Čo bolo zapečatené podľa toho verša?
2300. Yeah, the vision of the evenings and mornings.
Áno, videnie o večeroch a ránach.
So everything connected in the book of Daniel with the 2300 evenings and mornings.
Takže všetko, čo sa dotýkalo toho videnia o 2300 večeroch a ránach.
That was sealed.
To bolo zapečatené.
Now we know this is referring to the cleansing of the sanctuary.
A vieme, že toto sa odkazuje na očistenie svätyne.
We know it's referring to the time where the high priest would go into the most holy place.
Vieme, že sa to dotýka toho času, kedy najvyšší kňaz vchádza do svätyne svätých.
But this was not to be understood until the time of the end.
Ale to nemalo byť pochopené až v čase konca.
Actually, if you go to Hebrews,
v podstate ak sa pozrieme do knihy Židom.
It's very interesting if you go to Hebrews chapter 9.
Židom kapitola 9.
Where Paul is describing the earthly sanctuary in relation to the heavenly sanctuary.
Kde Pavel opisuje prepojenie tej pozemskej a nebeskej svätyne.
And when it comes to the most holy place,
a keď prichádza k svätyni svätých,
he says in verse 5,
hovorí vo verši 5, čiže Židom 9:5.
And above it were the cherubim of glory.
A nad ňou, nad truhlou,
overshadowing the mercy seat.
Cheruby slávy zatôňujúci pokrývku.
Of these things we cannot now speak in detail.
Zvanú zutovnica, o ktorých veciach hovorí dopodrobna nie je teraz možno.
Paul says literally.
Pavol doslova hovorí.
In my time I cannot say much about the most holy place.
V tomto čase, v tomto mojom čase nemôžem povedať veľa o tom, o svätyni svätých.
Why?
Prečo?
It's sealed.
Je to zapečatené.
Have you ever thought about this?
Mysleli ste na to niekedy?
That you as an Adventist.
Vy ako adventisti?
You understand more about the sanctuary than Paul.
Chápete viac o svätyni než Pavol.
Paul says in his time I cannot speak about this.
Pavol hovorí, že vo svojom čase o tomto nemôžem hovoriť.
We cannot speak about this right now.
Nemôžeme o tom teraz hovoriť.
So this should give you some excitement.
To by vám malo dať nejaké vzrušenie.
But let's go back to Daniel 12.
Ale vrátime sa späť do Daniela 12. kapitoly.
We learn that this should be closed until the time of the end.
Vieme, že toto by malo byť zavreté až do času konca.
What logical question should we ask now? What logical question should we ask now?
Aké logické otázky by sme sa mali pýtať my teraz?
When will be the time of the end, right?
Kedy bude ten čas konca, však?
Now, according to your Bible knowledge, when is the time of the end?
Tak teraz podľa vašej znalosti Biblie, kedy je čas konca?
When the book was open.
keď bola kniha otvorená.
Now,
after the 2300 years.
Really? Now think about
naozaj?
This. If the time of the end is after the 2300 evenings and mornings.
Považujeme o tom teraz. Ak je naozaj čas konca po 2300 večerách a ránach,
then nobody could understand it before it is fulfilled.
Tak nikto to nemohol pochopiť predtým, než sa to naplnilo.
So,
takže
I don't know.
Neviem.
Has anyone another idea?
Poznal niekto tú ideu?
When biblically is the time of the end?
Pozná niekto teda tú
otázku? Oh, 1798. How do you know? How do you know?
1798, ako vieš?
But why is this the time of the end?
Ale prečo?
Oh, Ellen White says, right?
Ellen White to hovorí však.
And she says so.
A hovorí tak.
But why does she say so?
Ale prečo to hovorí teda?
Let's find out from Daniel 12.
Objavme to teda z Daniela 12. kapitoly, zistíme to z
Daniela. Verse 6.
Verš 6.
The question is now asked.
Otázka sa teraz kladie.
And one said to the man clothed in linen.
A riekol mužovi oblečenému v ľanovom ruchu.
Who was above the waters?
Ktorý stál hore nad vodami rieky.
How long shall the fulfillment of these wonders be?
Kedy bude koniec tým divným veciam?
Now let's look at verse 7.
Teraz sa pozrieme do verša 7.
Then I heard the man clothed in linen who was above the waters of the river when he held up his right hand and his left hand to heaven and swore by him who lives forever that it shall be for a time, times and half a time and when the power of the holy people has been completely shattered all these things shall be finished.
Na to som počul hovoriť muža oblečeného v ľanovom ruchu, ktorý stál nad vodami rieky a videl som, že pozdvihol svoju pravicu i svoju ľavicu k nebu a prisahal na živého na veky, že na určený čas, určených čias a polčasu, a keď ukončia rozmetávať silu svätého ľudu, dokoná sa to všetko.
So Daniel is referred to a time where the people of God will be scattered and shattered.
Takže Daniel sa odkazuje na čas, kedy Boží ľud bude prenasledovaný a prenasledovaný, rozptýlený.
And this time would be one time, two times and half a time.
A ten čas bude čas, dva časy a pol času.
And if we go back to Daniel 11,
a keď sa vrátime späť do Daniela 9. kapitoly,
11. kapitoly, it says in verse 34 and 35, or 35 is enough, 35.
Vo verši 45.
Where it speaks about this 35.
35. Pardon.
Where it speaks about this scattering in the Middle Ages.
Keď hovorí o tom rozptýlení v stredoveku.
And some of them of understanding shall fall to refine them, purify them and make them white until the time of the end.
A niektorí z tých rozumných klesnú prečistiť medzi nimi sťa ohňom, očistiť ich a zbieliť až do konečného času, lebo to tak potrvá ešte až do určeného času.
So the Bible clearly teaches.
Takže Biblia jasne učí.
There's a time when God's people will be scattered and persecuted.
Že bude čas, kedy bude Boží ľud rozptýlený a prenasledovaný.
Until the time of the end.
Až do času konca.
And Daniel 12 verse 6 says this time will be one time, two times and half a time.
A Daniel 12 6. verš hovorí, že to bude obdobie času, dvoch časov a pol času.
Now as good Adventists, you know these three and a half times.
Ako dobrý adventista by ste mali poznať, adventisti by ste mali poznať tie 3 a pol časy.
1260. There are 1260 years.
Je to 1260 rokov.
Reaching from
vychádzajúc z
from
odkedy?
538
538
to
až do 1798.
So according to Daniel 12,
takže podľa Daniela 12. kapitoly,
the book shall be opened in 1798.
A kniha má byť otvorená v roku 1798.
So when we see Jesus coming down with the book opened,
takže keď vidíme Ježiša prichádzať dole s otvorenou knihou,
we can conclude Revelation 10 takes place in 1798.
Mali by sme vedieť, že teda tá udalosť sa odohráva v roku 1798.
Now let's ask a question.
Teraz sa opýtame otázku.
What happened in 1798?
Čo sa stalo v roku 1798?
The Pope Pius the 6th was taken captive.
Pápež Pius 6. bol vzatý do zajatia.
And he died one year later in exile.
A v exile zomrel o rok neskôr.
But what happened because of that?
Kvôli tomuto?
was that many Protestants
bolo, že mnoho protestantov
were thinking, wait a minute.
Si pomyslelo, počkajme.
Could this be the fulfillment of prophecy?
Môže byť toto splnenie proroctva?
You may have never heard of a man like Edward King.
Možno ste nikdy nepočuli o človekovi Edward King.
Ever heard of Edward King?
Počuli ste niekedy o Edwardovi Kingovi?
He was a lawyer in London.
He was a lawyer?
Lawyer.
Bol právnikom v Londýne.
Who in 1798
ktorý v roku 1798
discovered that we are actually now in the time of the end.
Prichádzame práve teraz do konca času.
And he and many others.
A bolo mnoho ďalších.
They wrote pamphlets and books.
A boli tam pamflety, knihy.
Saying the 1260 years have expired.
Hovoriace, že tých 1260
and this started in movement, especially
skončilo.
In Great Britain.
A to začalo také hnutie najmä vo Veľkej Británii, v Anglicku.
Where many Christians started to study prophecy.
Kedy mnoho kresťanov začalo študovať proroctva.
Because there was one other number that had not been fulfilled.
Lebo bolo tam ešte jedno číslo, ktoré nebolo naplnené.
The 1260 years were fulfilled.
1260 rokov bolo naplnených.
But there were these mysterious 2300 years.
Ale bolo tam tých tajomných 2300 rokov.
And so people tried to understand.
A tak ľudia sa snažili pochopiť.
At the same time in 1799.
A v tom istom čase v roku 1798
a man called Lacunza died. 1799. Yeah.
A man 1799.
A man named Lacunza died.
A muž menom Lacunza zomrel.
You have heard of Lacunza?
Počuli ste o Lacunzovi?
Oh, you have read The Great Controversy, right? Have you read The Great Controversy?
Čítali ste Veľký spor veko?
He is in the book.
Bol v tej knihe.
He was a Jesuit.
Bol to jezuita.
Who lived in South America?
Ktorý žil v Južnej Amerike.
Then went to Italy.
Potom prišiel do Talianska.
And then the Jesuits were forbidden.
A potom jezuiti boli zakázaní.
So he had no work to do.
Takže nemal čo robiť.
And he had a good decision.
A urobil dobré rozhodnutie.
He said, let's study the Bible.
A začneme čítať Bibliu.
And for 30 years he studied the Bible as a Catholic.
A 30 rokov študoval Bibliu ako katolík.
He was the first Catholic to discover after 1000 years.
Bol prvý katolík po 1000 rokov, ktorý objavil,
that the coming of Christ is imminent, that he will come back soon.
Že príchod Ježiša Krista je blízky a že nastane veľmi skoro. Je nevyhnutný a nastane.
He didn't understand all the prophetic numbers.
Neporozumel všetky tie roky, tie čísla.
But he wrote manuscripts.
Ale napísal spisy.
And these manuscripts were hidden knowledge in all of South America and Italy and France.
A tieto rukopisy boli skrývané všade po Južnej Amerike, Taliansku a Francúzsku.
Many people to ask what will happen in the future and to study the prophetic books.
Ktoré viedli mnohých ľudí k tomu, aby uvažovali nad tým, čo bude v budúcnosti, aby študovali tie prorocké knihy.
So there was a time where people were trying to understand more closely what Daniel Revelation are saying.
Takže bol čas, v ktorom začali ľudia viac študovať a snažili sa viac pochopiť, o čom hovorí ten Daniel a zjavenie.
They discovered that the late French Revolution was predicted in Revelation 11.
Objavili, že tá francúzska revolúcia bola predpovedaná v Revelation
11.
V zjavení 11. kapitole.
And then something happened.
A potom sa niečo stalo.
Around 1810-1811
okolo roku 1810-11
several people independent of each other
niekoľko ľudí nezávisle na sebe
discovered something that nobody has had discovered before almost.
Objavili niečo, čo takmer nikto predtým neobjavil.
Were people like John Aquila Brown
ľudia ako John Aquila Brown
in England
v Anglicku
or William Davis in the United States
alebo William Davis v Spojených štátoch.
They found out
objavili
that Daniel 9 is the explanation to Daniel 8.
Že Daniel 9. kapitola je vysvetlenie Daniela 8. kapitoly.
If you go back in church history,
keď sa vrátime do histórie k cirkvi,
we know only of one person in 2000 years before that actually understood this.
Nájdeme iba jednu osobu, ktorá pochopila toto v celej histórii cirkvi.
It was a man who found this out a few decades before.
Bol to človek, ktorý to objavil, muž, ktorý to objavil niekoľko desaťročí pred skôr.
By the way, he was a German.
Len mimochodom, bol to Nemec.
He lived near Frankfurt.
Žil pri Frankfurte.
And he found out in 1768 already.
A objavil to v roku 1768.
But his findings had no impact.
Ale jeho objav nemal žiadny dopad.
But now in 1810, 1811.
Ale teraz v roku 1810-11.
This new discovery really spread like wildfire.
Tieto nové objavy sa rozšírili ako oheň.
And there were many people that we even as Adventists don't know about anymore.
A bolo tam v tom aj mnoho ľudí, o ktorých my ako adventisti vôbec teraz nevieme.
Like William Cunningham.
Ako napríklad William Cunningham.
From England.
Z Anglicka.
Archibald Mason.
Archibald Mason.
From Scotland.
Zo Škótska.
And many others.
A mnoho ďalších.
There was a guy called Hans Peter in the Netherlands. Hans Peter.
Bol to človek Hans Peter. Z Nemecka.
And all of these understood independent from each other, Daniel 8 and Daniel 9 go together.
A všetci títo ľudia nezávisle na sebe zistili, že Daniel 8 a 9. kapitola idú spolu ruka v ruke.
Truly Jesus had a message for his people, the Protestants.
A skutočne Ježiš mal posolstvo pre svojich ľudí v protestantoch.
He wanted to prepare them for the coming event.
Chcel ich pripraviť na nastávajúce udalosti.
But out of all of them.
Ale zo všetkých z nich všetkých?
Oh, let me just say this.
Len mi dovolte povedať ešte toto.
Have you heard of a man called Joseph Wolf?
Počuli ste o mužovi s menom Joseph Wolf?
Joseph Wolf?
Joseph Wolf.
Oh, you should read the Great Controversy again.
Ak nie, tak mali by ste prečítať zase Veľkú spravodajku. Tiež sa tam spomína.
He was an English missionary.
Bol to anglický misionár.
He was a man who went through all of Turkey and Near East.
Bol to človek, ktorý prešiel celé Turecko a Blízky východ.
Egypt, Iraq, Iran.
Egypt, Irak, Irán.
Afghanistan. Even into India.
Až dokonca do Indie.
To proclaim that Jesus would come around 1847.
Aby hlásil, že Ježiš príde okolo roku 1837.
By the way, 47. He was born in Germany.
A len tak mimochodom narodil sa v Nemecku.
Anyway. He was called the missionary to the world.
A bol vlastne misionár pre svety.
And he was part of a movement in England.
A bol súčasťou toho hnutia v Anglicku.
Who around 1826, 27, 28.
Ktorý v okolo roku 1826, 27, 28.
Already preached that Jesus would come around 1843, 1847, something like this.
A už hlásali, že Ježiš príde v okolo roku 1843 až 47, niekedy v tom čase.
It was not as organized as later in America.
A nebolo to také organizované ako neskôr v Amerike.
But there were many very famous preachers preaching that message.
Ale bolo veľa naozaj známych kazateľov, ktorí toto kázali a hlásali.
One of them was Edward Irving.
Jeden z nich bol
Edward Irving.
Edward Irving.
When he preached,
keď on kázal,
you had to go 1 hour before the service in order to get a seat.
Museli ste prísť aspoň hodinu pred tou pobožnosťou, aby ste si mohli sadnúť.
And he did not preach in little houses, he preached in large churches.
A on nekázal v malých domoch, ale v obrovských kostoloch.
And these people really shook the great Britain.
A títo ľudia naozaj otriasli Veľkou Britániou.
But unfortunately, this British Advent awakening kind of fell together.
Na nešťastie toto anglické adventné hnutie sa rozpadlo.
Because fanaticism appeared.
Pretože sa objavil fanatizmus.
People believed in speaking in tongues.
Ľudia začali veriť v rozprávanie jazykov.
They believed in being specially led by the Holy Spirit in certain curious acts.
A verili, že boli v istých zvláštnych a divných konaniach vedení Duchom Svätým.
And so there were splits and it kind of crumbled to down.
A tak boli rôzne rozkoly v tom hnutí a sa to rozpadlo na mnoho malých.
Out of this the new apostolic hnutí. Church actually arose.
Z tohto vznikla nová apoštolská cirkev.
And nová other groups that are prominent today.
A ďalšie skupiny, ktoré sú dnes pomerne veľké.
But at the start it was really God's leading trying to awake people for this time frame around 1844.
Ale na počiatku tam bol naozaj Boh, ktorý viedol svoj ľud, aby sa pripravil na ten čas okolo roku 1843.
But when we go to Daniel 12 again,
ale keď sa vrátime späť do Daniela 12. kapitoly,
we find that the Bible points to a certain movement at that time.
A nájdeme, že Biblia ukazuje na isté, na konkrétne hnutie v tom čase.
We saw in verse 4,
môžeme vidieť vo verši 4,
that many shall run to and fro and knowledge shall increase.
Že mnohí budú spýtovať a rozmnoží sa vedomosť.
Many people would run through the prophecies and try to compare scripture to scripture.
Že mnohí budú študovať Bibliu a porovnávať prorostvo s prorostvom, pasáž s pasážou.
And new light would flash on Daniel and Revelation.
A padne nové svetlo na Zjavenie a Daniela.
And you can really see in all parts of the world, in South America, North America, Asia, Europe.
A to ste mohli vidieť v rôznych častiach sveta, v Južnej Amerike, v Severnej Amerike, v Európe.
You can find people who believed about this state around 1844.
Ktorí verili o tom stave, ktorý mal nastať roku 1800, okolo roku 1843.
One very funny story.
Jedno veľmi vtipný príbeh.
A missionary from Ireland.
Ireland?
Ireland. Not Ireland, like Great Britain and Ireland.
Ireland. Jeden človek z Írska.
He went to Central Asia in 1820.
Vošiel, teda odcestoval do stredu Ázie v roku 1820.
And he went to Central Asia in 1820.
V roku 1820 do strednej Ázie.
You know the Tatars? That's a tribe there.
Tatari.
To the Tatari. And
Tatarom.
He preached to them the gospel.
Kázal im evanjelium.
And then the priest of the Tatars asked him the question.
A vtedy sa ho kňaz Tatárov opýtal.
When according to your opinion will Jesus come back?
Kedy Ježiš podľa tvojho názoru sa vráti?
And the Irish missionary said nobody knows that.
A ten írsky kazateľ povedal, to nevie nikto.
And then the Tatar priest said,
a ten tatársky kňaz mu povedal,
you are Christian missionary?
Ty si kresťanský misionár?
And you don't know when Jesus comes back?
A nevieš, kedy sa Ježiš vracia?
We have read the Bible.
My sme čítali Bibliu.
We are sure Jesus comes back 1844.
Sme si istí, že Ježiš sa vráti roku 1844.
It's a true story.
Je to skutočný príbeh.
It's in the great controversy, by the way.
Tiež je to vo veľkom spore vekov.
And so you can find many stories about that.
Nájdete o tomto vlastne veľa príbehov.
But let's go back to Daniel 12.
Ale vráťme sa späť do Daniela 12. kapitoly.
When Daniel gets this answer that the time of the end shall be in 1798.
Keď Daniel dostáva tú odpoveď, že koniec času bude v roku 1798.
He did not understand.
Tak to nechápal.
Look verse 8.
Nerozumel tomu. Pozrite sa do verša 8.
Although I heard.
A ja, keď som to počul.
I did not understand.
Nerozumel som tomu.
Then I said.
Povedal som.
My lord.
Môj pane.
What shall be the end of these things?
Čo bude potom všetkom?
So here's the scenery.
Takže takáto je scenéria. Takáto je scéna.
He sees that there will be a time of the end.
Vidí, že bude koniec času.
The question is asked, when will be the time of the end?
Otázka bola, že kedy bude ten koniec času?
God answers, you know, from 538 to 798, then will be the time of the end.
A Boh mu odpovedá, že tak od roku 538, v roku 1798, vtedy príde ten koniec času.
But Daniel doesn't understand.
Ale Daniel tomu nerozumie.
Now in case you want to try to explain something,
Tak teraz v prípade, že chcete vysvetliť niečo,
but the other person doesn't really understand.
Ale tá druhá osoba tomu nerozumie.
What will you do?
Čo urobíte?
Try again, right?
Vyskúšate znova však.
But most likely you will use slightly different words, right?
Ale pravdepodobne asi použijete trošku iné slova.
You will try to get from a different angle.
Pokúste sa na to pozrieť z iného uhla pohľadu.
To the same goal, right?
Na rovnaký cieľ.
So we know already 1798 is the time of the end.
Už vieme, že 1798 je koniec času.
But now God is trying to get to this date by a different angle.
Ale Boh sa teraz snaží pozrieť na tento dátum, na tento koniec z iného uhla.
Verse
z iného dátumu času. Verš 11.
And from the time that the daily sacrifice is taken away and the abomination of desolation is set up,
a od toho času, keď bude odstránená ustavičná obeť, aby na jej miesto bola daná pustošiaca ohavnosť,
there shall be 1290 days.
Bude 1290 dní.
So that's from a different angle.
Takže je to z iného uhla.
Going to the same goal.
Idúc na ten istý cieľ.
What is the goal?
Čo je tým cieľom?
What date?
Ktorý dátum?
The time of
date. Yeah, what date?
Koniec času, áno, ale ktorý rok? Ktorý rok?
1798, right?
1798 však.
Now when I go 1290 years back.
A keď sa vrátim 1290 rokov späť.
What must be the starting point of that prophecy?
Čo musí byť začiatočným bodom toho proroctva?
508.
508 rok.
Right? From 508.
Z roku od roku 508.
It is 1290 years to 1798.
Je to 1290 rokov do toho roku 1798.
Are we all on the same page?
Chápeme
sa? You all understand?
Všetci tomu rozumieme?
So we have now 508 as another starting point.
Čiže máme teraz rok 508 ako ďalší začiatočný bod.
And now what's something very interesting.
A teraz prichádza niečo veľmi zaujímavé.
Next verse.
Ďalší verš.
Blessed is he who waits.
Blahoslavený ten.
And comes to the 1335 days.
Kto čaká a dospeje ku dňom 1335.
508.
508.
1290 days.
1290 dní.
1798.
1798.
But blessed is he.
Ale blahoslavený je ten.
Who waits.
Ktorý čaká.
Who waits a little bit longer.
Kto čaká trošku dlhšie.
To 1335 years.
Na tých 1335 rokov.
So, in other words, someone who waits 45 years longer.
Inými slovami, ten, kto čaká o 45 rokov viac.
What time do we, to what time do we come?
K akému času, k akému roku dôjdeme, keď pridáme tých 45 rokov?
In verse 12.
V tom verši 12.
1843. Can you all see this?
Vidíte to všetci?
The Bible says there's a time prophecy reaching to 1843.
Biblia hovorí, že biblické proroctvo, ktoré siaha do roku 1843.
Now, you know maybe the story.
Pravdepodobne všetci poznáte tento príbeh.
There was a farmer in Lowhampton, New York.
Bol jeden farmár Lowhampton.
Lowhampton.
V jednom meste Lowhampton pri New Yorku.
His name was?
Jeho meno bolo?
William Miller.
William Miller.
He had been a captain in the US Army.
Bol to kapitán americkej armády.
He was a skeptic. He didn't really believe that God is engaged in this world.
Bol to skeptik, ktorý neveril veľmi, že Boh bol zapojený do týchto slov.
But in 1816,
ale v roku 1816,
he was converted.
Sa obrátil.
And he really started to study the Bible.
A naozaj začal študovať Bibliu, začal naozaj študovať Bibliu.
He started in Genesis 1.
Začal v Genesis 1. kapitole.
He just took a Bible.
On zobral Bibliu.
And a concordance.
A konkordanciu.
And he just read and compared scripture to scripture.
A len čítal a porovnával písmo s písmom.
It took him 2 years.
Zabralo mu to 2 roky.
When in 1818,
keď v roku 1818,
he wrote,
napísal,
I'm convinced,
som presvedčený,
Jesus will come back around 1843.
Som presvedčený, Ježiš sa vráti na zem okolo roku 1843.
But now, he didn't go out to say, oh, I have to preach.
Ale on nevyšiel vonku a nezačal rozprávať. On musím o tom kázať.
Many of us would do this, right?
Mnohí z nás by to pravdepodobne urobili však.
New light, you have to listen to me.
Nové svetlo, nové svetlo, musíte ma počúvať.
William Miller took after 2 years studies.
William Miller po 2 rokoch štúdia.
He took 5 years of comparing his notes.
Si zobral 5 rokov na to, aby porovnával svoje poznámky.
Of searching for possible errors.
Aby hľadal možné chyby, ktoré mohlo dojsť.
Because when he believed that Jesus would come soon,
pretože keďže veril, že Ježiš príde skoro,
this was against the belief of the church of his day.
To bolo proti všeobecnej viere cirkvi v tých dňoch.
People believed the entire world would become Christian.
Tí ľudia v cirkvi verili, že celý svet sa stane kresťanským.
People believed the Jews would go back to Palestine.
Ľudia verili, že Židia sa vrátia do Palestíny.
And Miller all discredited this by the Bible.
A Miller vlastne týmto všetky tieto viery zdiskreditoval.
So in 1823 he was ready and he has established his understanding. 1823.
V roku 1823 teda už mal v tom jasno a skontroloval si to.
But still he didn't preach.
Ale aj tak nešiel kázať.
He was not a theologian.
Nebol to teológ.
He did not know how to preach.
A nevedel ako kázať.
He was a simple farmer.
Bol to obyčajný farmár.
So he waited another 8 years.
Tak čakal ďalších 8 rokov.
Can you imagine that?
Viete si to predstaviť?
And in 1831.
A v roku 1831.
It was in August.
Bolo to v auguste.
He was on his farm working.
Bol na svojej farme, pracoval.
And always there was a voice in his head.
A zrazu ničoho nič mal, bol hlas v jeho
Go. A voice in his head.
Always.
Continue.
Ale stále mal v hlave ten hlas hlas.
There was a voice saying, "Go and tell the world."
Ktorý mu hovoril: "Choď a povedz to svetu."
Go and tell the world.
Choď a povedz
to
svetu.
No, I'm not able to do.
Nie, ja to nedokážem.
And then in 1831.
A potom v roku 1831.
Finally the voice was so strong.
Napokon konečne bol ten hlas taký silný.
He made a covenant with God.
Že spravil zmluvu s Bohom.
He knelt down.
Kľakol si.
And said, "God, I will go."
A povedal: "Boh, ja pôjdem."
But only
ale
if someone invites me to preach.
Iba ak niekto príde a pozve mňa, aby som kázal.
And he stood up.
A postavil sa.
I was very happy.
Bol veľmi šťastný.
Because in all his life never he had got an invitation to preach.
Pretože nikdy v živote right? nedostal žiadne pozvanie na kázanie.
So he knew it will never happen.
Takže vedel, že sa to nikdy nestane.
And he was so happy with himself.
A bol taký šťastný sám so sebou, taký spokojný.
And up in heaven.
A hore v nebi.
God was smiling.
Boh sa usmieval.
Because while he was praying.
Pretože kým sa on modlil.
Already a young man was on his way.
Už mladý muž bol na ceste, aby ho pozval.
To invite him for next day to a sermon.
Aby ho pozval na ďalší deň kázať.
So when the young man knocked on the door.
Takže keď ten mladý muž zaklopal na dvere.
And said, "Mr. Miller."
A povedal: "Pán Miller."
"We don't have a pastor next Sunday."
Nemáme ďalšiu nedeľu kazateľa.
"Can you come and preach?"
Môžeš prísť a kázať?
William Miller.
William Miller.
Didn't say a word.
Nepovedal ani slovo.
He left the home.
Opustil dom.
Ran into the garden.
Bežal do záhrady.
Prayed 1 hour.
Modlil sa hodinu.
With this young man standing at the door.
S tým mladým mužom, ktorý stál vo dverách.
Not knowing what to do.
Nevedel, čo má spraviť.
And after 1 hour.
A po hodine.
This man who went in as a farmer.
Ktorý vošiel ako farmár.
Came out a preacher.
A vyšiel z tej záhrady ako kazateľ.
Preaching the date 1843.
A kázal o tom roku 1843.
In 1836.
V roku 1836.
After 5 years going from village to village.
Po 5 rokoch chodenia z dediny do dediny.
He wrote a book.
Napísal knihu.
Showing that according to his belief Jesus would come back in 1843.
Ktorá ukazovala, že podľa jeho viery, podľa toho, čo verí, Ježiš sa vráti v roku 1843.
By the way.
A mimochodom,
if you look to Daniel 12.
Ak sa pozriete do 12. kapitoly Daniela.
According to the Bible.
Podľa Biblie.
What would happen in 1843?
Čo sa stane v roku 1843?
It's about blessing.
What would happen? What event would happen?
Čo sa aká udalosť sa stane v tom roku 1843?
The sanctuary will be cleansed.
No. In Daniel 12 nie. Verse 12.
Daniel 12 verš 12.
Is there anything mentioned about the sanctuary?
A je tam vôbec niečo spomínané so svätyňou?
What event is mentioned here?
Čo je tam spomenuté? Aká udalosť?
Nothing. Very good.
Nič. Veľmi
dobré. Because the prophecy is only about someone who waits for the date.
Pretože to proroctvo je iba o niekom, kto čaká na ten dátum.
It doesn't say that anything happens at the date.
Nehovorí, že v tom right? čase sa niečo stane.
It is only those who wait for 1843.
Je to len o tých, ktorí čakajú do toho roku 1843.
They are blessed.
Že oni sú požehnaní, blahoslavení.
Nothing will happen in 1843.
Nič sa nestane v roku 1843.
But the Bible predicts there will be people waiting for 1843.
Ale Biblia predpovedá, že budú ľudia, ktorí budú čakať na ten rok.
And the entire Millerite movement was waiting for 1843.
A celé to millerické hnutie čakalo na ten rok 1843.
Now.
Nuž.
Until 1838.
Až do roku 1838.
Miller was virtually alone.
Miller bol viac menej sám.
But in 1838,
ale v roku 1838
the first famous preachers who joined him
sa k nemu začali pripájať prví takí známi
were for example
kazatelia.
Josiah Litch.
Napríklad Josiah Litch.
You heard of Josiah Litch?
Počuli ste o Josiahovi Litchovi?
It's a great controversy.
Tiež je to vo veľkom spore vekov.
He was the one who actually wrote a book saying 1840.
Bol to naozaj jeden, ktorý napísal knihu, že v roku 1840
The Ottoman Empire, the Turkish Empire will give away its autonomy.
Napísal, že v roku 1840 Otomanská ríša rozpustí svoju vládu, rozpadne sa.
And during the days 1838, 1839, 1840
a počas tých rokov 1838, 39, 40
he even specified the date August 11, 1840.
Dokonca upresnil dátum, že to bolo 18. august 1840.
You know what happened August 11, 1840?
Viete, čo sa stalo 11. augusta, pardon, to bolo 11. august.
The Turkish
1840,
Empire,
turecká ríša,
gave its autonomy to the European powers.
Odovzdala svoju autonómiu európskym mocnostiam.
It was one of the most sensational and spectacular fulfillments of prophecy in modern times.
Bolo to jedno z tých najväčších a najzázračnejších splnení proroctiev v modernej dobe.
Thousands after thousands were convinced that Miller and his associates were right in their year-day principle.
Tisícky ľudí boli presvedčení, že Miller a jeho stupenci boli mali správne teda tie roky učené.
In 1839.
V roku 1839
Miller was asked to preach in a church in Boston.
Millera požiadali, aby prišiel kázať do kostola v Bostone.
There was a young pastor.
Bol tam mladý kazateľ, pastor.
His name was Joshua Hines.
Jeho meno bolo Joshua Hines.
He was not fully convinced about Miller's theory.
Nebol úplne presvedčený o Millerovej teórii.
So after the sermon,
a tak po tej prednáške, po kázni,
Himes comes to Miller.
Himes prichádza k Millerovi.
And says, "Do you really believe what you preach?"
A pýta sa ho, "Naozaj veríš tomu, čo hovoríš?"
And Miller says, "Yes, of course."
A Miller hovorí, "Samozrejme."
So you think that in 3 or 4 years the world will burn up?
Tak ten Himes sa ho pýta, "Tak teda naozaj veríš, že o 3-4 roky celý svet zhorí?"
And Miller says, "Yes."
Miller hovorí, "Áno."
And then Himes said something remarkable.
A vtedy Himes podal niečo pozoruhodné.
He said, "If this true."
Ak je to pravda.
Every city in the United States must hear.
Každé mesto v Spojených štátoch to musí počuť.
Up to this point Miller had just traveled from one village to another village.
A doteraz Miller cestoval len z jednej dediny k druhej dedine.
But Himes was a manager.
Ale Himes bol manažer.
He was a strategic planner.
Bol to strategický plánovač.
And he said, "We must make a campaign."
On povedal, musíme si pripraviť kampaň.
We must reach Washington and New York and Philadelphia and Boston, all of these cities.
Musíme zasiahnuť Washington, Philadelphia, New York, všetky tieto mesta.
And from this one person moving around,
a z tejto jednej osoby, ktorá chodila po tých dedinách,
it became a Millerite movement.
Vzniklo vlastne millerické hnutie.
They established newspapers.
Založili noviny.
Called the Sign of the Times.
Signs
of the Times.
Ktoré nazvali znamenia doby.
The Midnight Cry.
A polnočné volanie.
And they did everything they could.
A urobili všetko, čo mohli.
In order to spread this message like wildfire.
Aby toto posolstvo rozšírili ako oheň.
If you see the movements,
ak vidíte hnutia,
it's like 1838.
Je to ako 1839.
1839. 1838. 1839.
39.
1840.
40.
1841.
41.
1842.
42.
It's like pium.
Išlo to exponenciálnou krivkou.
It is absolutely remarkable what these guys did.
Bolo to naozaj pozoruhodné, čo tento človek urobil.
In 1842.
V roku 1842. Pardon.
In 1842.
V roku 1842.
They had a great general conference.
Bola generálna konferencia, veľká konferencia.
And they said, "We must have better means."
A kde sa vlastne zhodli, že potrebujú lepšie prostriedky.
Let's have camp meetings.
potrebujeme stanové zhromaždenie.
You know what a camp meeting is?
Viete, čo je stanové zhromaždenie?
It's 10,000 people camping in the woods.
Je to 10 000 ľudí stanujúcich v lese.
No cars.
Žiadne autá.
No electricity.
Žiadna elektrina.
No refrigerators.
Žiadne chladničky.
No water.
Žiadna voda.
10,000 people in the woods.
10 000 ľudí v lese.
They built the largest tent in all of the United States.
Postavili najväčší stan v celých Spojených štátoch.
And we have reports.
A máme záznamy.
On Tuesday this big tent was taken down.
Že v utorok bol tento veľký stan zložený dole.
In one city.
V jednom meste.
And on Thursday morning it stood already in another city.
A v štvrtok ráno už stál v nejakom inom meste.
Many miles away.
Mnoho míľ ďalej.
They were sacrificing everything.
Obetovali všetko.
Because they believed Jesus would come soon.
Pretože verili, že Ježiš príde čoskoro.
But still it was not enough.
Ale stále to nebolo dosť.
One of their numbers,
jeden z ich členov,
called Charles Fitch.
Zavolal Charlesovi Fitchovi.
You've heard of Charles Fitch?
Zavolal Charles Fitch.
You've heard of Charles Fitch?
Poznáte meno Charles Fitch?
He's mentioned in early writings.
Je spomínaný v raných spisoch.
Charles Fitch had an idea.
A Charles Fitch mal nápad.
To create a chart.
Aby vytvoril diagram.
Where all the main prophecies of Daniel Revelation,
kde sú hlavné proroctvá Daniela a Zjavenia,
can be seen at a glance.
Kde tieto proroctvá môžu byť vidieť proste pri jednom pohľade.
And the Bible actually had predicted that.
A Biblia dokonca toto predpoveda.
Let's go to Habakkuk.
Poďme do proroka Habakuka.
Habakkuk chapter 2.
Habakuk kapitola 2.
Habakkuk chapter 2 verse 2.
Habakuk 2. kapitola verš 2.
Then the Lord answered me and said,
a Hospodin mi odpovedal a riekol,
write the vision and make it plainer on tablets.
Napíš videnie a to zretelne na doskách.
Then he may run who reads it.
Aby čitateľ prebehol po ňom.
So the idea is,
takže tá myšlienka za tým je,
the prophecy should be made so plain,
že tie proroctvá budú tak jasné, tak
that even someone who's running,
predstavne tak jasné, že aj niekto, kto beží,
by just a casual glance at it,
len takým tým bežným pohľadom, s bežným pohľadom,
can understand it.
Môže ich pochopiť.
So not that you're stopping and you're looking what is
nie, že zastanete a budete si pozerať a študovať, že čo je toto, čo
by
je toto.
Running you should be able to catch the idea.
Dokonca aj pri behu by ste mali byť schopní pochytiť tú ideu, tú myšlienku.
Which is a good principle for us.
Čo je dobrý princíp pre nás.
We should make our message so plain and clear.
Mali by sme naše posolstvo spraviť takým jasným a jednoduchým,
that everyone can understand it.
Že každý by mal ho byť schopný pochopiť.
And during these years.
A počas týchto rokov.
1842, 1843. It really shook the United States.
To naozaj zatriaslo Spojenými štátmi.
Newspapers were reporting about these Millerites on the front page.
Noviny písali o týchto Milleritoch na titulných stránkach.
There were all kinds of bad rumors about them.
Bolo o nich množstvo zlých klebiet.
Even the economy advertised using Millerite slogans. Like, you know,
using Millerite.
Millerite slogans, for example.
Dokonca aj ekonomické noviny používali millerické slogány v reklame.
Those who were selling cigarettes,
napríklad tí, čo predávali cigarety,
they would make a placard,
pripravili si plaketu
with angels flying in heaven,
s anielmi letiacimi z neba,
saying the time is at hand.
Hovoriac teda so slogánom
you don't have much time to smoke anymore.
Nemáte už veľa času na to, aby ste fajčili.
So use your opportunity now.
Takže využite svoju príležitosť teraz.
Can you imagine this?
Viete si to predstaviť?
If the advertisement,
ak tie reklamy,
is using those slogans and pictures,
používajú tieto slogány a obrázky,
it's only because of one reason.
Je to len z jedného dôvodu.
It's because everyone was talking about it.
Pretože každý o tom rozprával.
When was the last time you went through Cottage and you saw Adventist imagery in the advertisement?
Kedy bolo poslednýkrát, keď ste šli cez po ulici? Po ulici a videli ste nejakú reklamu, ktorá používala adventistické slogany alebo obrázky?
And so these people were sacrificing everything, all the money they had.
Takže títo ľudia obetovali všetko, všetky peniaze, čo mali.
There was a man called Joseph Bates.
Bol tam muž menom Joseph Bates.
He had been a captain, he was rich.
Bol to kapitán, bol bohatý.
He sold everything he had.
Predal všetko, čo mal.
Went into the south of the United States and preached the gospel.
Išiel na juh Spojených štátov a kázal evanjelium.
They went to the north to Canada.
Išiel na sever do Kanady.
They went to the wild west.
Išiel na divoký západ.
Some of them went to England.
Niektorí z nich dokonca šli aj do Anglicka.
And they had contact to people in Germany and in other places and in Netherlands.
Mali kontakty aj v Nemecku, v Holandsku.
And they were truly believing Jesus would come in the year 1843.
A naozaj verili, že Ježiš príde v roku 1843.
But the Bible clearly says nothing would happen in 1843.
Ale Biblia jasne hovorí, nič sa nestane v roku 1843.
We only know that movement.
Vieme len to, že to hnutie,
that looked for 1843,
ktoré čakalo na ten rok 1843, bolo blahoslavené.
It was the people of God that were following the angel of Revelation 10.
Bol to Boží ľud, ktorý nasledoval Ježiša alebo toho anjela zo zjavenia 10. kapitoly.
And when the angel and when 1843 passed,
a keď rok 1843 prešiel,
the Jewish year 1843 went to the spring of 1844.
Ten židovský rok 1843 trval až do roku 1840 do jary 1844 toho nášho počítania.
And when this had passed,
a keď toto sa minulo, tento rok sa minul,
there was a disappointment.
Bolo tam sklamanie.
But when they read Habakkuk,
ale keď čítali Habakuka,
in Habakkuk 2 verse 3,
v druhej kapitole verš 3,
it says,
je napísané,
but the vision is yet for an appointed time.
Lebo ešte bude videnie na určený čas.
But at the end it will speak.
A spiecha ku koncu a neoklame.
And it will not lie.
A neoklame.
Thou art tedious.
Keby predlelo.
Wait for it.
Čakaj naň.
Because it will surely come.
Lebo prísť istotne príde.
It will not tarry.
A neomeška.
So they found out.
Takže objavili.
There's a tarrying time. A time of tarrying.
Že je čas predlženia? Predlenia, predlženia.
They found out that somehow they're they have to wait a little bit longer.
Pochopili, že musia čakať o niečo dlhšie.
So in the summer 1844.
Takže v lete 1844.
50,000 millerites.
50,000 mileritov.
Who now called themselves Adventists.
Ktorí sa v tom čase začali volať adventistami.
Looking for
sami
the
seba.
Advent of Christ.
Čakajúc na advent Ježiša Krista, na príchod Ježiša Krista.
They said we are now in the tarrying time.
Povedali, my sme teraz v tom čase predlženia.
We always waited for 1843.
Vždy sme čakali na rok 1843.
We don't know for what wait to wait, for what date to wait.
Nevieme, na aký ďalší rok máme čakať.
But we think it will be soon.
Ale myslíme si, že to bude skoro.
And so they prayed.
A tak sa modlili, teda
and studied.
Modlili, kázali, študovali.
And worked even harder.
A pracovali ešte tvrdšie.
And then there was a camp meeting in August 1844.
A potom bolo ďalšie stanové zhromaždenie v auguste 1844.
The people were already a little bit tired of waiting.
Ľudia už začínali byť trošku unavení z toho čakania.
There were several preachers.
Bolo niekoľko kazateľov.
One was Joseph Bates.
Jeden bol Joseph Bates.
And he preached.
On kázal.
And preached.
A kázal.
And preached.
A kázal.
And the crowd was, yeah, we know already what he's saying.
A tí ľudia, tie zástupy boli také, že
he wasn't very charismatic.
Vieme, o čom hovorí.
And he said we are the tarrying time.
Charizmatický.
And we are the tarrying time, and you know, let's wait.
Predlženia, predlenia.
Let's wait.
Tak čakajme.
And while he was preaching,
a kým on kázal,
a man was riding.
Muž jazdil
on his horse.
Na svojom koni.
Very fast.
Veľmi rýchlo.
And he reached that camp meeting in Exeter, New Hampshire.
In Exeter,
that's the place, Exeter.
A prišiel teda do toho, na to stanové zhromaždenie v Exidore.
He jumped from the horse.
Zoskočil z konia.
Took the horse, you know, and secured it.
Priviazal konia.
And then he ran into the tent.
Vbehol do stanu.
And he was kind of, you know, he was coming into the tent.
Vchádzal do stanu.
He was coming in.
Vchádzal dnu.
And while Joseph Bates was preaching very, you know, very tired.
akým Joseph Bates kázal tak veľmi unavene, tak
and you know very boring,
veľmi nudne.
Samuel Snow, that was his name.
Samuel Snow.
He sat down next to a lady.
To bolo jeho meno.
And he started to talk to her.
Sadol si k
He started to talk to her.
To whom?
To the lady next to her.
Sadol si nejakej žene a začal k nej hovoriť.
Do you know?
A povedal jej, vieš?
I found out something.
Niečo som objavil.
We have to wait for autumn.
Musíme čakať na jeseň.
Because there's a seventh month in the Jewish year.
Pretože to je ten 7. mesiac v židovskom kalendári.
That's the great day of atonement.
Čo je ten veľký deň zmierenia.
And we have to wait for that date.
A musíme čakať na ten dátum.
And then of the lady.
Vtedy sa tá pani, tá žena.
The sister stood up. You don't have to stand
up. Sa postavila.
And she stood up and said, "Wait a minute."
A povedala, počkajte.
We have enough of your sermon.
Máme dosť vášho kázania.
There's someone here who can give us a real sermon.
Je tu niekto, kto nám môže dať ozajstnú kázeň.
And Joseph Bates was humble enough to say, "Okay, let him speak."
A Joseph Bates bol dostatočne pokorný na to, aby povedal, OK, tak nech káže on.
And so Samuel Snow preached that message.
A tak Samuel Snow kázal toto posolstvo.
That he already had preached on several other places.
A ktoré kázal už tedy na viacerých miestach predtým.
But here in Exeter it really came to a climax.
Ale tu viac menej náhodou sa to dostalo do toho zenitu.
He conclusively showed.
Jednoznačne ukázal.
That Jesus or that the 2300 days, let's say this.
Že tých 2300 rokov
will end in October 1844.
Sa skončia v októbri 1844.
That there has been a miscalculation respecting the date.
Že tam bolo nejaká miskalkulácia, nejaká chyba pri tom počítaní.
Because there is no year zero.
Pretože nie je žiadny rok nula.
And he showed from the typology of the Old Testament that Jesus must come in October.
A tak ukázal z typológie toho tej starej zmluvy, že Ježiš musí prísť v októbri 1844.
And what then happened is absolutely you cannot even imagine.
A to, čo sa vtedy stalo, si to neviete ani predstaviť, je to nepopísateľné.
It is called the seventh month movement.
Je to nazvané 7-mesačné hnutie. Hnutie 7. mesiaca.
Tak they had only 2 months.
Hnutie 7. mesiaca.
And they reached every village, every city, every hamlet in the United States of America.
A za 2 mesiace zasiahli každé mesto, každú dedinu, každú samotu, úplne všetko.
Interestingly enough, it was not the leaders that were leading out.
A to, čo je na tom zaujímavé, neboli to tí vodcovia, ktorí to viedli.
Himes and Miller and Leach were against it at first.
Himes, Leach a Miller boli vlastne proti tomu hnutiu z počiatku.
Only during the last weeks they actually came on the board.
Len počas niekoľkých posledných týždňov sa pridali na palubu k ním.
It were lay persons.
Boli to tí laici.
Lay persons.
Boli to laici, ktorí to
and young preachers like James White.
A mladí kazatelia ako James White.
That took this message like wildfire to the people.
Ktorí vzali toto posolstvo a rozniesli ho ako oheň medzi ľudí.
And they waited for 1844 October 22.
A čakali na október 22. október 1844.
If you read the newspapers a few weeks before,
ak by ste čítali noviny pár týždňov predtým,
you get goosebumps. You know goosebumps?
Dostali by ste husiu kožu.
It is absolutely you cannot even imagine. Like I cannot really describe it to you. You have to read it for yourself.
Neviete si to ani predstaviť, museli by ste si to prečítať sami.
There's
sami
a prečítať. Power in that movement, a spirituality that is absolutely indescribable.
V tom hnutí bola taká moc, taká duchovná moc, že si to neviete ani predstaviť.
People were giving their very last for it. Like they're giving everything for it.
A dali úplne všetko, čo mali, všetko, čo mali do
toho. Charles Fitch, for example.
Charles Fitch, yeah. Fitch, napríklad Charles Fitch.
He was baptizing people in October.
Krstil ľudí v októbri.
Without having anything to warm himself.
Bez toho, aby mal niečo, aby sa sám zohrial.
And when he had baptized people,
a keď krstil tých ľudí,
he went out in his wet clothes.
Vyšiel von v tých svojich mokrých šatách.
In the cold October.
Do studeného októbra.
To walk many miles to another city.
Aby kráčal v takých mokrých šatách do ďalšieho mesta.
Finally he went ill.
Nakoniec samozrejme ochorel.
And he died October 14, 1844.
A zomrel 14. októbra 1844.
8 days before the date.
8 dní pred tým dátumom.
There are people like James White.
Boli tam ľudia ako James White.
He was traveling even in the winter.
Ktorí cestovali dokonca aj v zime.
And he was traveling at one place speaking to the people.
A prišiel na jedno miesto, kde hovoril k ľuďom.
And it was already dark.
A už bola tma.
And when he had finished, he had to go to another place.
A keď skončil, potreboval ísť do ďalšieho mesta.
And
na ďalšie miesto.
Stay here, it's too late.
A oni mu hovorili, že nie, ostaň tu, je už neskoro.
But he said, I have to go.
On povedal, nie, musím ísť.
He took his horse.
Zobral svojho koňa.
And without having sufficient clothes.
A bez toho, aby mal dostatok šiat.
He was riding miles after miles.
Jazdil míle za míľami.
Coming to another church.
Aby prišiel do ďalšieho zboru.
Who was waiting for one hour.
Ktorý čakal hodinu.
And they were already on their way home.
Už boli na ceste domov.
When he came in and said, oh, I'm here.
A prišiel tam, povedal, že počkajte, tu som.
And he would stand at the pulpit.
Postavil sa ku kazateľnici.
It was so cold, he even couldn't speak because his teeth were like...
A bola mu taká zima, že nemohol ani hovoriť, že mu až klepali zuby.
These people were full of faith.
Títo ľudia boli plní viery.
There are newspapers, articles.
Sú noviny,
články v tých novinách. Of a guy called T.M. Preble. T.M. Preble.
O mužovi s menom T.M. Preble.
One of the very few that kept the Saturday Sabbath at that time.
A jeden z mála, ktorí vtedy dodržiavali sobotu.
Who said, you know, it's October 9.
Ktorý povedal, že je to október, 9. október.
I've only have a few days.
Ktorý povedal, že už je október 9. Mám len niekoľko dní.
I will visit these towns.
Ale navštívim tieto mesta.
Pam, 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 pam.
Vymenoval mesta, proste.
Incredible.
Takýmto. Úžasné.
Let's go to Habakkuk 2, verse 4.
Poďme do Habakuka, which chapter?
2 verse 4.
2. kapitoly, verš 4.
Behold the proud.
Hľa, nadutá je.
His soul is not upright in him.
Nie je priama jeho duša v ňom.
But the just.
Ale spravedlivý
shall live.
Bude žiť
by his faith.
Svojou vierou.
October 22nd came.
Október 22. október prišiel.
It was a Tuesday.
Bol to utorok.
Imagine next Tuesday is the end of the world.
Predstavte si, že ďalší utorok je koniec sveta.
What would you do?
Utorok, čo príde.
If
čo by
in
ste
two days Jesus would come back.
Keby o dva dní mal prísť Ježiš.
How would you spend this Sunday, this next Monday?
Ako by ste strávili túto nedeľu, tento ďalší pondelok?
How would you spend that Tuesday?
Ako by ste strávili ten utorok?
They waited.
Oni čakali.
And they sang songs and prayed and studied the Bible.
Spievali, modlili sa, čítali Bibliu.
And time went on.
Čas išiel.
It became afternoon.
Prišlo popoludne.
Became evening.
Prišiel večer.
And still they thought like maybe Jesus coming at the very end of the day.
A oni si stále mysleli, že možno ten Ježiš príde úplne na konci toho dňa.
And it was 8 p.m.
A bolo 8 hodín večer.
10 p.m.
10 hodín večer.
11 p.m.
11 hodín.
11:30.
A pol 12.
11:45.
3 štvrť na 12.
Can you imagine?
Viete si to predstaviť?
11:50.
11:50.
11:55. Jesus is coming back in the next 5 minutes.
5 minút pred 12:00, Ježiš mal prísť o 5 minút.
11:58.
11:58.
And finally the clock went.
A napokon prichádza hodina na
ping
na tú 12:00.
Ping.
Ping. Boom.
Ping.
A odbíja tá 12:00 hodina.
12 times.
12 krát.
Jesus was not come back.
A Ježiš neprišiel.
The great disappointment.
A veľké sklamanie.
And my friends.
A priatelia.
Out of 50,000 Adventists.
Z 50,000 Adventistov.
That were all singing come back Jesus.
A ktorí všetci spievali o príchode Ježiša Krista.
Only 50.
Len 50
had faith enough.
Mali dostatok viery,
to believe that something had actually happened on October 22nd.
Aby verili na tomu, že niečo sa naozaj stalo v tom októbri 1844.
Faith is living by every word.
Viera žije z každého slova.
Even if you cannot see anything.
Aj keď nič nevidíte.
They could not see anything.
Oni nevideli nič.
They could not hear anything.
Nič nepočuli.
They could not feel anything.
Nič nevedeli pocítiť.
And so the great majority.
A tak valná väčšina.
Came to the conclusion.
Prišla k záveru.
Nothing has happened.
Nič sa nestalo.
There is no October 1844 date in Bible prophecy.
A nie je žiadny október 1844 v biblických proroctvách.
They were trying to find new dates.
Snažili sa nájsť nové dátumy.
1845, 1846, 1848.
1845, 46, 47.
But the movement had gone down.
Ale hnutie sa rozpadlo a
and only 50
upadalo.
People.
A iba 50 ľudí
out of 50,000
z 50 tisíc
had courage enough
mali dostatok odvahy
to say
povedať
I do not see anything
nič nevidím
I do not hear anything
nič nepočujem
but the Bible says that 1844 is the end
ale Biblia hovorí, že 1844 rok je koniec
therefore something must have happened
preto sa niečo muselo stať
I believe the word
verím slovu
I don't believe my eyes
Neverím svojim očiam.
I believe the word.
Verím slovám.
I don't believe my ears.
Neverím svojim ušiam.
And those 50.
A tých 50
discovered the heavenly sanctuary.
Objavili tú nebeskú svätyňu.
They were Hiram Edson.
Bol to
Hiram Edson.
Hiram Edson.
Joseph Bates.
Joseph Bates.
Alan Harmon.
Alan Harmonova.
James White.
James White.
People that have had no great importance at the early Millerite movement.
Ľudia, ktorí nemali nejaký veľký vplyv v tom rannom millerickom hnutí.
They followed Jesus from the holy to the most holy.
A nasledovali Ježiša z toho svätého miesta do svätyne svätých.
It was all predicted in Daniel, Revelation and Habakkuk.
To bolo všetko predpovedané u Daniela v zjavení a u Habakuka.
Everyone who would cling to his Bible.
Každý, kto sa upel k svojej Biblii,
would follow Jesus.
A sledoval Ježiša.
It was a test of faith.
Bola to skúška viery.
Would you have still searched for an answer?
Hľadali by ste vy ešte stále odpovede?
Or would you have said, oh, we just made a mistake, let's look for another date.
Alebo by ste si povedali, že urobili sme chybu, poďme hľadať nejaký iný dátum.
William Miller never accepted the Sabbath and the heavenly sanctuary.
A William Miller nikdy neprijal sobotu a nebeskú svätyňu.
Himes never accepted it.
Himes to nikdy neprijal.
Josiah Litch gave up later all his prophetic understanding. He gave it up. He said it's wrong.
Josiah Litch sa vzdal všetkých svojich prorockých výkladov a povedal, že všetko
Samuel Snow, the one who had given the midnight cry, he gave up his faith.
Samuel Snow, ktorý dal to polnočné volanie, tak sa úplne vzdal svojej viery.
Some of them even became spiritualists.
Niektorí z nich dokonca prišli, sa stali spiritistami.
Spiritists. T.M. Preble, the one who had kept the Sabbath, went back to keep the Sunday.
T.M. Preble, ten, ktorý dodržiaval tú sobotu, sa vrátil späť k nedeli.
All the leaders except for Joseph Bates.
Všetci tí vodcovia až na Josepha Batesa
gave up their faith.
Sa vzdali svojej viery.
And I believe.
A ja verím.
The reason why Joseph Bates is the only leader that actually stayed with the word of God.
Ja verím, že dôvod, prečo Joseph Bates bol jediný z tých vodcov, ktorý naozaj zostal veriť teda tomu Božiemu slovu,
has to do with the fact.
A sa týkal toho faktu,
that he was the only one at that time keeping health reform.
A ktorý bol jediný, ktorý v tom čase dodržiaval zdravotnú reformu.
His mind was very clear.
Jeho myseľ bola veľmi jasná.
He lived like Adventists are living today.
A žil tak, ako adventisti žijú dnes.
At that early time.
Už v tom čase, skorom.
My friends.
Priatelia.
Why do I tell you all of this?
Prečo vám toto všetko hovorím?
For several reasons.
Z niekoľkých dôvodov.
First.
Za prvé.
You need to know that our movement is based on Bible prophecy.
A musíte vedieť, že naše hnutie je postavené na biblických proroctvách.
Not only our doctrine is based on Bible prophecy.
Nie, nasze učenie je na biblickom proroctve.
But the very roots of our history are depicted in Daniel, Revelation and Habakkuk.
Ale už aj samotné korene nášho hnutia sú zobrazené alebo ukázané u Daniela, Habakuka a Zjavení.
As well as in other chapters like Matthew 25.
Takisto ako v ďalších kapitolách alebo ako je Matúš 26.
Secondly.
A za druhé.
Ellen White says.
Ellen White hovorí,
that the last work,
že posledné dielo
will go in forth in the same power as the seventh month movement 1844.
Bude o rovnakej sile ako bolo to hnutie 7. mesiaca v roku 1844.
You should study this movement.
Mali by ste študovať, skúmať to hnutie.
In order to see how God will finish this work.
Aby ste videli, ako Boh ukončí toto svoje dielo.
And thirdly,
a za tretie,
don't assume.
Nepredpokladajte,
that just because you're an Adventist right now,
že len preto, že ste adventisti práve teraz,
that you will stay an Adventist after the crisis hits.
A zostanete adventistami aj potom, čo udrie tá kríza.
50,000 Adventists?
50,000 Adventistov.
The crisis came?
Prišla kríza.
The great disappointment?
Veľké sklamanie.
50 stayed.
Ostalo 50.
That's a lesson for us.
To je pre nás lekcia.
And most of them they were seen as the leading lights of Adventism.
A väčšina z nich bolo vidieť ako to vedúce svetlo adventizmu.
They were gone
boli
away.
Boli považovaní za vodcov.
They were going away.
Tak väčšina z nich bola v tom hnutí, v tých ľuďoch, čo odchádzali.
Don't assume.
Nepredpokladajte.
That just because you're sitting today.
Že len preto, že tu teraz sedíte,
you will be still an Adventist after the crisis comes.
Budete adventistami aj potom, čo príde kríza.
Don't assume that.
Nepredpokladajte to.
But learn a lesson from the past.
Ale poučte sa z minulosti.
That even if you're a weak, humble woman like Ellen Harmon.
Že aj keď ste slabá a skromná žena ako Ellen Harmonová.
Or an unknown brother like Hiram Edson.
Alebo neznámy brat ako Harmon Edson. Hiram Edson.
You can stand an Adventist if you have faith in God's word.
Môžete zostať stať v adventizme, ak máte vieru v Boha.
Who of you wants to say?
Kto z vás chce povedať?
We have nothing to fear for the future.
Nemáme sa čoho báť v budúcnosti.
Except we forget.
Iba toho,
how God,
že zabudneme. Iba ak by sme zabudli.
Except we forget how God has led us in the past.
Iba ak by sme zabudli, že ako nás Boh viedol v minulosti.
I want to learn a lesson from that experience.
A ja sa chcem poučiť z tej skúsenosti.
And I want to spend more time studying our own roots.
A chcem venovať viac času študovaniu našich vlastných koreňov.
Your desire?
A je to aj vaša túžba?
Let's pray together.
A poďme sa spolu modliť.
Let's stand up for that.
A budeme stať.
Dear Father in heaven.
Drahý nebeský Otče.
We want to thank you for this time together.
Chceme ti ďakovať za tento čas, ktorý sme spolu prežili.
Thank you for opening our eyes.
Ďakujeme ti za otvorenie našich očí.
To the facts of Advent history.
K tým faktom adventistickej histórie.
But even more importantly to the lessons that we can learn from Adventist history.
Ale ešte, čo je ešte dôležitejšie, tak aj k tým lekciám, ktoré sa môžeme poučiť z adventistickej histórie.
You have said to us.
A povedal si nám,
that we have nothing to fear.
Že sa nemáme čoho báť.
For the future.
Z budúcnosti.
Unless we forget how you have led us in the past.
Ak len nezabudneme to, čo si nás naučil v minulosti.
And sadly enough.
A čo je smutné?
Often we do not know our own past.
Častokrát ani nepoznáme vlastnú minulosť.
And Satan can bring in the same problems and the same temptations.
A Satan tak môže prinášať tie isté problémy a tie isté pokušenia.
Over and over again.
Znova a znova.
Let us become wise.
Daj, aby sme boli múdri.
By studying the past.
A študovaním minulosti.
Let us learn from the victories.
Daj, aby sme sa poučili z víťazstiev.
And from the failures.
A zo zlyhaní.
Of our pioneers.
Našich priekopníkov.
That we may be able to finish this work.
Aby sme mohli ukončiť túto prácu, toto dielo.
to bring this last message of your judgment.
Aby sme mohli priniesť toto posledné posolstvo tvojho súdu.
To the dying world.
A k umieracemu svetu.
In Jesus' name we pray.
V Ježišovi sa modlíme.
Amen.
Amen.